all talk and no action. And he doesn't like it when people call him out.
I mean, you sit there and you listen to everything he says. As soon as you key up,
he's a tough guy behind the microphone. You stand face to face with him and suddenly his hands are down and he's mellow and he's a good guy and all that.
He's just whining because he didn't like one of my comments. It wasn't even to him and he's whining about it. Why don't you go grow up?
Man, I care that it was a friend of mine.
Grow up.
House and you start...
Grow up.
Yeah, but it was his friend, huh?
Yeah, she called me on the phone. It's okay. It's all right.
Oh, no. I said her face looked exactly like her butt.
Yeah, she asked me why that guy said that to her. I said, don't worry about it. He's supposedly a friend of mine. And then she listened to me get in an argument with him about it. And now she's apologizing to me.
Because she said the word exactly, and that's where the joke comes from. It says, someone says exactly, it doesn't matter who it is. That's what you say sometimes, just to be funny. I'm sorry you didn't like the little joke. I'm done talking to you, fucking whiner.
That's why he got a divorce the first time.
God, Beavis, you really got a rodeo going today.
I know, off of a three-year-old little joke. Maybe you should just shut up.
Fuck me, come over here.
Here we go with threatening again. Y'all riled up.
You know I did, so I'm awake. Come on.
You sound like you're really grumpy.
What is he going to
do? I'm really not. I'm just getting disappointed in my two fucking friends. Do you have any of those? I got about 500 of them. And they're all good people. None of them fucking fuck with me ever.
I don't have any friends, unfortunately, just because I have a hard time finding loyal ones.
Yeah, once in a while, they'll put up a fucking 12-inch knife in the middle of my back, and then I'm not friends with them anymore. But up until then, I trust people, and I go through a lot of shit with people, and I help people, and I usually never hurt people in any way, shape, or form.
Yeah,
and you doing today, Carter?
Yeah, we heard you. I'm just a little passionate when it comes to women, and especially if they're a friend of mine.
I like women, too.
I love women. It's a big difference, Arthur.
Treat it with respect. I remember when you were over here, you said, if I take off my shirt, will you show me yours? Huh. If that didn't make her feel uncomfortable.
Well, I hope it didn't, because she knew that we were both laughing. Because I wanted to take mine off, because I was sweating. That's why I mentioned it. She was trying to hide, and I told her she didn't need to, because I wasn't looking. And I was doing that out of respect to you, always and always will. Pay attention.
I did. Why do you think she went inside and stayed inside after you made the comment? And that's all I gotta say. Have a good day.
Yeah, okay, Beavis. I don't wanna fuck your girlfriend, and you and her both know that. Grow the fuck up.
Didn't say anything about that. You were talking about respected women, and where the fuck did that come from? You grow up.
Beavis, that's after she came out and we were all making jokes for a while. Period. Don't make something out of nothing.
Yeah, if I said that to Tanya, you'd get all pissed off, so you just go away.
No, I wouldn't, because we'd all be sitting in the same room together and we'd all be joking, so I'm done with your little game. Put your toys away.
I'll admit, Beavis' girlfriend's pretty cute.
She's a nice lady. It's too bad she has to sit there and listen to all the words that come out of her boyfriend's mouth.
She's sitting here thinking you're a retard right now.
Okay, well, okay. Really?
Uh-huh, she heard it from the beginning.
Okay.
Beavis sure has a pretty mouth.
Well, thank you.